Good morning, students. Today we are going to have a live exercise session. That is, we have done a lot of punctuation and all that stuff. Today we are going to revise all your thing, because tomorrow, this Saturday, is going to be the first test where you will be scored on your complete SAT score of 1600, and out of 800 you have to take the test. Okay, so let's start. Just have a first fast revision about punctuation and just have a look at it. And you have already experienced the kind of passage you will be getting. You will not be getting individual passages. The individual passages that I give you here is just a gist of the individual questions that I give is just to tell you and to simplify the whole thing. But otherwise, it will be all given in a passage, and then you will have to keep answering the questions. Today we are going to do the punctuation exercises, just a revision of what we have already done before. I have at length taken your questions, taken the classes session, so that it is very, very clear. But still, if there are any misconceptions or anywhere you feel that you still need some help, you can just get back to me. Otherwise, let's do a quick revision of all the punctuation marks, and then we'll do the exercises, a lot of exercises today. Okay, so today for the first word, let us just understand quickly what punctuation is. Punctuation is the use of conventional characters, comma, semicolons to improve clarity. Now, it also gives style, it gives makes the comprehension better, and the reader knows where to pause and where to stop. Okay, so that is what a punctuation does. So let us have a quick look at all the main word punctuation marks. The first punctuation is a apostrophe. It definitely comes with possessive determiners, and it is basically very important. It comes with possessive determiners, so please understand. If you have not understood where to put your apostrophe in the possessive determiners, please go back to the session articles and possessive determiners and have a look at it. You will definitely get your answers there. The next one is the parenthesis. We have also done at length parenthesis in sentence boundaries and stuff, where we use this round brackets or those curly brackets or the square brackets for different kind of information that we would want to impart. So they are also, when you you want to give more descriptive information about a subject and you don't want to use a comma, or you can use the brackets. Okay, the next one is a parenthesis square. You have this square parenthesis. Now, parenthesis square is a outer part of an inner part. So you might have done your BODMAS, and in that BODMAS you might have learned the kind of usage of passages, usage of brackets, curly brackets and square brackets. So the same rules apply here too. The next one is a colon. When you are using a colon, it is more about introduction of a list or something like that. It's a formal usage of starting a list. The next comes a comma. Now, comma is very complex. It can create comma splice. It can create a lot of troubles if you are not very clear with commas. So we have already done a lot of things about in and around comma. So we will go about further. Dashes. Now you have the colon, and both the comma, colon and the dash basically serve the same purpose. They introduce a list. But when you want to introduce something formally, we use colons, and when we want to use something informally, we start with dashes. Ellipses. Ellipses are something like that when it is obvious, you don't have to explain it, and the married life goes on, and put a 3 dots. That's it. It is obvious that it will have its ups and downs and it will still carry on. So that kind of a thing, when you are trying to talk about, then comes your ellipses. I would have loved to talk to you, but ellipses. I don't think it was really necessary, or I know how it is going to go, or anything like that. Okay, the next one is exclamation mark. When you are using an exclamation mark, it is about your exclaim. This is a sudden surprise or a strong emotion. When you want to do that, we use an exclamation mark. The next one is a hyphen. whenever you are using an iPhone, it is basically used to combine two covers, so to make the compound words. So you use a hyphen like an x-axis or a y junction or a, you know, U-turn. You put a U and the dash and a hyphen and then a roll, turn. Okay, the next one goes to periods. Now this is a full stop. This is the last thing that you would want to do, the end of a statement or, you know, the end of an imperative sentence. So this gives you, it's stop. You, whatever we are explaining, the end of that of the sentence is a full stop. The next one is a question mark. If it is an interrogative sentence, if you have questions all around you, you always have to start, end with a question mark to gain the answer. Next comes the quotation marks. Now, quotation marks gives a very important plays a vital role. It is about whenever you want to quote something, whenever you are telling something indirectly, then you quote it. That is the what is the quotation, the work of the quotation mark. And last but not the least is a semicolon. The usage of semicolon is definitely not as easy as it looks. You really need to ace it, otherwise it is going to mess up. So these are the commonly used punctuation marks in our writing, reading purposes. Yeah, when we are reading, definitely we don't read them, but they give you a direction as to pause or as to stop or as to go on. So they will give, you have to articulate your speech in that manner according to the punctuation marks that is given. For example, if you have a comma, you have to pause for 1 second. If you have a full stop, you have to pause for 2 seconds. And if you have a semicolon, you have to pause for 1.5 seconds. That is how it goes. So the longer the pause, it means full stop. The lesser the pause, it means a comma. So please understand that. Okay, so that's how the whole thing goes. And let's see the next. Let's have a quick review of all the punctuation marks that we have already learned. Apostrophes are used to show position. One's dog kennel, two dog's kennel. Yes, you have done this before. Just a recap so that you don't mess up again. Okay, in time expressions like a day's holiday, in contractions like can't, don't, isn't, it is, or something like that. And then apostrophes are not used to show plurals. Three dogs, two patios. Okay. Randomly used before the word, yes. See, you cannot use it like this. Three dogs, you don't say that. You just remove this and then you use the word. Okay. So, randomly before the yes, yes, she likes cake. No, you don't do that. Okay. So, these are something that you don't use it. You don't use it like this. The next one is the colons. And the colons are basically used to extend the sentence, to expand on something previously mentioned in the sentence. Like, for example, I need just one personal trait, loyalty. And it is also used after an introduction. For example, you want to introduce something. I have seen the following: rust, slime, and a rat. So what you are doing is you are actually introducing a list. The next one is in reference to times and titles. For example, Real Genesis 1:1 before 9:9. So this is what, whenever you are expressing time, you definitely use a colon there. Whenever you are using the Genesis, whenever you are using references, you also use it this way. The next one is with quotation marks. He said quotation mark, and you start the quotation. And sometimes you also use comma instead of colons. Most of the times you basically use a comma instead of a colon. But sometimes when you want to. Okay, now the comma, the usage of comma is very, very often, we almost use it in every sentence, a comma is used. So we need to understand that comma is just not one or two or three things, but it's almost 15 to 16 ways in which a comma is used. So the usage of comma has to be understood explicitly. I have definitely done lots and lots of exercises, and I have also been telling you where to use a comma, sentence fragments, sentence, all these things. Definitely, I definitely had 3 or 4 sessions on punctuations before and have explicitly discussed about commas. If you have not understood, please go back to those sessions and just revisit them. It is going to really help you, because commas is a common punctuation mark that is used in your daily life and also in the reading or the writing purposes. So, and it will also help you to gain better marks in your better score in your evidence-based reading if you gain expertise. So let's have a quick review about commas. Commas are after setting the scene at the start of a sentence. Now she's wiser, she understands. So whenever you are having a simple, complex sentence, I mean, whenever you have an independent sentence before a complex, independent sentence, you put a comma to start the independent sentence. Now she is wiser, she understands. So like this. So next is after transitional phrases like however, consequently, or as a result, however, I now agree with you. So before, after this adverbial phase or transitional phases, we definitely use a comma. So that's a very small part of it. I would have expanded more, but then we are in, I'm just doing a quick recap. So this is just a recap class session where we have to do a lot, concentrate on doing the answers rather than understanding the definitions. Hyphens, yes, hyphens are joiners. They are used to join words in a compound adjectives, in a compound verbs. A 7-foot table, a silver service banquet, to join words in compound nouns, for example, paperclip or cooking oil. Their main purpose is to show the joined words are a single entity. Now, after the hyphen has been used, single adjective or a single noun. Now, this is a single word. Okay, so even if you are counting characters, you have a colon, it will not take it as two words. If you are counting a number of words, it will not take it as two words, but because the hyphen is there, it will take it as one word. They are also useful to avoid ambiguity. Hyphen makes it clear that a paper clip is a clip for paper and not clip made of paper. So that's what it is. Parenthesis round, we use this parenthesis, round parenthesis, to give extra information, to insert an extra information, often an afterthought or clarification or expansion of a recently mentioned idea. Set in the 17th century, the Three Musketeers. Now, this is Three Musketeers. Now, they have given it in French also, the name of the Three Musketeers in French. So, now they have used that in parenthesis or brackets, because it does not make sense to put a comma and give that, because it is just an extra additional information that they are giving. Okay, is a novel by Alexandre Dumas. To present a plural option with a singular one. So, you know, whenever sometimes your guests must leave before midnight. Now, it could be guests, it could be guests. You put a parenthesis to say if you have just one guest, they have to leave before midnight, and if you have more than one, they also have to. So, whether it is a guest or a guest, they have to leave before midnight. So, that's about parenthesis. Now, let's have a quick review of the square braces. Now, square braces are less used, and to make quoted text clearer by expanding on or replacing the part of the quote. For example, if you don't like them, well, I have others. Now, the parentheses are, these square brackets are used to specify or clarify something more, specific. To make it clear that like sink and da are insertions by the current author, not the originator. So in your statement, I appreciate him of the situation at about 4 o'clock. So this is how it is used, but comparatively, this is the least used punctuation mark. The period, yes, whenever we require a full stop, we definitely use this period. And let's check once. A period or a full stop is used in UK, and a period is used in US. So it's a punctuation mark used at the end of the sentence, a declarative sentence or a statement. For example, I eat pies. That's it. That's a statement. At the end of an imperative sentence, which is not forceful enough for an explanation work. Please use the bathroom upstairs. That's a request. In an abbreviation, including initialisms and contractions. For example, BBC, professor. Now, whenever this is an abbreviation. So, whenever we have an abbreviation like Bachelor of Arts or M Master of Science, something like that, then we put M dot, the full stop, and science. That's basically used for abbreviations. Okay, The next one is, now professor is a big word, but we are stopping it just as prof. So after that, a full stop to say that it's an abbreviation. Now the semicolon. Semicolons are a bit, dicey. We have to be very clear about what it is and where it is and how it is used. So we just can't play around. So let's see, what are they used for? In lists, when the list items contain commas. Now Peter, comma, the officer in charge, colon, the chef, and Heidi, my dog. Now they are three different people, so we have a semicolon to remove them. Now I need a different part of the, some more part of the sentence which is not given there. But now all these three people, I'm introducing all these three people, and then I have to say something. Okay, so that is very important to create a smoother transition between sentences, particularly when a second starts with a phrase like however or as a result. See this, I was freezing, however, comma, we still enjoyed it. Now, it was freezing. Now, one more easier way to identify a semicolon is, if you can put a full stop, you can put a semicolon. If you can put a comma, you can definitely use a semicolon. But sometimes the usage of semicolon becomes tougher, like when you are changing the subject into an object. Okay, now it was freezing. It was freezing was basically, we are talking about something else. However, we enjoyed it. When we are talking about somebody, now you don't have the subject here. We is not a subject here. It was freezing. So you were getting cold, right? You were the object here. Still, that was not mentioned. And yet you became the subject in the second sentence. Therefore, that is where a semicolon really plays an amazing way of, transition. The transition becomes very, very smooth when you use a semicolon. But you need to know how you have to use it, and you need to slide it so beautifully that it really looks like a beautiful transition. You don't feel the break. Okay, semicolons are not used for introduction, like colon or a dash. So I would blame one thing for my divorce beer. No, that's not. It should be a colon there, because I'm introducing something and semicolon is not used to introduce something. The next one is a quotation mark, and we have already understood what quotation marks are. Quotation marks, or speech marks as they are also called, are used. Now, you can use single quotation marks and also double quotation marks. It is basically, it has no much difference. It's the same. It's just that UK uses one and the US uses one. So let's check this. Ragan said, Reagan said, you can tell a lot about a fellow's character by his way of eating jelly beans. Now, we can put a colon here and we can also put a comma here. But what he said, when I want to quote Reagan, I would use a quotation marks. For the names of things like ships, books and plays. Now, I want to introduce something. I want to talk about a play, Hamlet. Quotation marks. And then you can talk about it. That's how you use it. And generally, single quotation marks are used, double quotation marks are also used. It just depends that they mean the same. There's no much difference there. Okay, so that's about quotation marks. And now, let's see the questions. Now, we're going to use a lot of questions. We're going to have a lot of options. So, just stay tuned. I'll give you a lot of time. Each one question, we will have almost 1 minute time to solve it. So make sure that you're doing it well, okay? So the annual cheese rolling at Cropper's Hill is a festival in Gloucestershire, England, where contestants race after a wheel of cheese to find out who can catch it. So what is it? Which it are we talking about? Just have a look. I don't think this requires much explanation. Yes, Mugda has started answering, and she says, no change. Yes, amazing. This is Suswara. Suswara also says, hi ma'am, this is Suswara. She's changed the number, I presume. So now she's answering. Please, come on, let's start getting the answers from all of you. Don't waste your time, please. Yeah, for the first one, yes, there is no change. We have a full stop and it is a complete the right. So we are not going to chase anything there, choose anything there. Let's go to the next question. Imperative. Historically recognized as the first known doctor lived in Egypt from 2667 to 2648 BCE and left a legacy of medical writings that replied on his knowledge of anatomy, anatomy and disease. This is one more easy question. I think the answer is C. I have not yet got answer for this. Yashwan, good morning. Yes, he also says no change. Amazing. Part 2 also says option 2. Option 2 of what, Parthu? Part 2 says question number 2 is C and it's right. Very good. Let's go to the next question. Disease, full stop, yes. Yashwan, start. Try to write the option numbers. I mean, either A, B or C. That will be easier. Okay, come on. Let's go to that third question. An ancient stone structure called the Wheel of Jains, a series of concentric circles in the Golan Heights region of the Middle East, has archaeologists stumped as to its meaning and how it was created. The wheel is 5,000 years old. Let's see the options. Now try to put down your options first and then we can go about it. Let's see the options. I want the answers. Come on, let's start. Yes, Mugda says the answer is 3, created and the. Why can't you say as, see it, okay, 3. Okay, yeah, thank you so much, Mugda. Gautam also says 3. Gautam says 3, option 3. Okay, fine. Thank you so much. Vivek says, I think what? Option 2, ma'am. No, it's not option 2 because they're two independent sentences. Let's put a full stop and start. Let's go to the next question. Before starting the marathon, Joel asked Jabrina if she had a spare water bottle. He had left his at home. Yes, Gautami, I know that. Thank you so much. Third one is no change. No, it's wrong. Third one says is 3. Sayed is also answering. Now we are past Tejashri. Yes, you are right. The fourth one is Rajshekhar gave the first answer. The fourth one is Mugda also has given the fourth option. And the first one is? No, you're wrong. All of you are wrong. No, Gautami, you're wrong. Parthu says B, wrong. Vivek says B, no, it is wrong. Yashwin says, ma'am, it is C. The two independent sentence, why does it have to have a different answer? Just check. Before starting the marathon, Joel asked Jabrina if she had a spare water bottle, full stop. He had left his at home. If there was a semicolon, definitely that would have been a better answer. But we don't have a semicolon here. Therefore, full stop is the right answer. I just told you that whenever you can put a full stop, you can put a semicolon too. Let's go to the next question. The tourist was amazed by the panoramic view from the Golden Gate Bridge. On her blog, she later declared with perfect grammar that it was stunning. Fifth one. Guys, you already have 30 to 40 seconds for that option, right? In that meanwhile, don't you think that you can just work it out like this instead of trying to find an answer? Is to understand, if you had written that sentence, how would you have written it? That's the easiest way of improving your knowledge and also an easiest way to find the right answer. Yes, can I know the answer? 5 says no change. Gautami says no change. Parthu says no change. Syed says B. The tourist was amazed by the panoramic view from the Golden Gate Bridge. I'll tell you why it is it and not they. She's talking about the view. She's talking about the view, and the view is in singular form. She said a panoramic view. View is basically an uncountable noun. Therefore, it is the right answer. Yes, it was stunning, was her expression. Therefore, no change is the right answer. Let's go to the next question. Anish and Carrie had both entered their pumpkins into the Jane Pumpkin Contest and way off to find out who was more successful this year. The winner would take home a cash prize and free tickets to next year's state fair. Let's see the options. What do you think is the right option? Which one do you think is the right option? Do you think we should have a question mark or a full stop, or is the comma right? Everybody is puzzled. Rajshekhar has got an answer. Gautami has an answer. Parthu deleted his answer. Yes, Yashwant has given his answer. Vivek, are you guys? Gautam has given the answer. Mugda, right? And the answer is B. All of you are going right. Yes, when one, we don't put a question mark, comma there, we cannot have a question mark also there. The best thing is, the answer is B. Let's go to the next question. Eat your Brussels sprouts or else I will ground you. My mother hollered at me from across the hallway. Let's see the options too. What is the answer, guys? Seventh one is Gautam has given the answer. Vivek, Sayed. Why did you call Suswara? I'm in the class. Abhiram, yes, all of you are right. The answer is B. Let's go to the next question. So the answer is not C, which my mother is not needed. Neither the fourth one, colon, is needed. Therefore, the best answer is second one, U and apostrophe, I mean exclamation mark, because it was a sudden surprise for the other person. Eat your Brussels sprouts or else I will ground you. Okay, so second, 7-2 is the right answer. Let's go to the next question. I hope you understood, all of you understood why I have taken the second one. In a perfect world, wouldn't it be nice if everyone who wanted a pet and had the ability to take care of it could do so? Without worrying about weight limits or apartment building restrictions. Let's see the options. Yashwant has already given his answer. In this question, most of you have given no change. I understand why, where it is coming from, but in a perfect world, comma, wouldn't it be nice if everyone who wanted a pet and had the ability to take care of it could do so? Isn't it a question mark there? This is just an extra information. The answer is D. Clear? Just have a look again, read the sentence again so that you will understand why I have taken the answer as D and not no change. Is it clear now? there is a wouldn't it be nice? That is the wouldn't you like to do it? Question mark. Would you like to do it? Question mark. Let's go to the next question, number 9. Olivia could not tell was Friday's mystical special at the cafeteria a freshly made casserole or just a combination of leftovers from the week's previous meals. What is the option? The options will change. Question 9. Yashwant has given the answer. Parthu gave the answer. But we need to close the parenthesis. Didn't we close the parenthesis, Gautam? I'm just going back to the next last question, 8th one. We close the parenthesis too, right? We close the parenthesis and then we gave the question mark there. Please check. Ninth one is, somebody says, option 3. Ninth one, please check the answer again. How can it be an exclamation mark? How can it be an ellipsis? Please check your answers. Ninth one, no change. How can it be no change? See, Olivia could not tell. Was Friday's mystery meals at the cafeteria a freshly made casserole or just a combination of leftovers from the week's previous meals? Abhiram, A. The answer is 4. It is something like, was it you? Question mark there. Therefore, was is already there. So that is what it's a question. She could not tell. Was Friday's mystery special at the cafeteria freshly made casserole or just a combination of leftovers from the week's previous meals? So it's a question mark. The answer is 9-4. Please go. That's the reason I told you when I put a comma there that the options might change. Right? Please understand why I keep telling certain things. Let's go to the next one. Did you know that Marie Curie not only was the first woman to win Nobel Prize, but is also the only woman person to win Nobel Prizes in multiple science fields? Which one is the right answer? I don't think you require 30 seconds to write this answer. Yes, I got the answer from Mugda. Yashwant, your answer is wrong. Gautam, your answer is wrong. Yashwant, your answer is wrong. Gautami, yes, you're right. So Swara, your answer is right. Parthu, your answer is wrong. The answer is no change because the question has started from did you know that Marie Curie not only. So did definitely is a question, it can be used as a question, and therefore the answer is no change, A. Tejashree, I have given the answer, please check. Let's go to the next one. Rajshekhar, I have already given the answer is A, not B. A cooperative board game pandemic asks players to work in teams to defeat threats. Players are assigned specific roles within the game, such as medic or scientist. Please choose one of the following options. So let's see what is it. Check the options. Tejashree, I got your answer. Where are the others? Are they all sleeping? Abhiram, you are right. Yashwant, you are right. Rajshekhar, no. Suswara, yes, you're right. Vivek, yes, you're right. The answer is, yes, Abhiram, you're right. The answer is 3, 11, 3. Tejashree, you're right. Let's go to the next question. Goodbye, she yelled, her voice growing louder over the roar of the train's engine. I will miss you. Let's check the options. Do you really think that you require a lot of understanding about this? Don't you think it is understood? Sayed, how come the answer is C? Can we come tell you, Abhiram and Sayed, how can the answer be C? Yes, Tejashree, Sayed, Gautami, Abhiram, so many people have given C. Yeah, I try to give an answer. I asked you, why do you think it is C? I think it is because it's a surprise, right? When somebody is saying a goodbye and somebody says, I will miss you, that's a surprise for the other person or sometimes to themselves too. That's why the answer is C. Let's go to the next one. She was trying to yell something after us with the door closed, cutting off her speech. Make sure that you don't. Let's see the options here. Yes, all of you, your answer is right. The answer is the second one, because after that the voice got cut, so we can only put an ellipsis to understand what you might have said. Let's see this. If you are going to eat in front of the fridge, at least close the door. The answer is 14th one. The answer is D. Yes, you have to put a full stop. Let's go to the second one. Next one. Whenever you go, make sure you are at least prepared for the weather. Let's see the options. 14th. We are done with 14th students. Let's go to 15th. Let's go to 15th. Yes, Rajshekhar, the answer is right. It is weather, full stop. Let's go to the next one. Whether or not you choose to move away from home or for college is ultimately up to you. 16th one. Let's see the options. Yes, the answer is 4. If the 15th one answer is 4. For the 16th one, yes, Sayed, you are right. Tejasri, you are right. Yashwant, you are right. Gautami, you are right. Suswara, you are right. Yes, for the 16th one answer, I got it from Gautami. For the 16th one, the answer is C. Let's go to the next one. It's a full stop there, nothing more than that. Barrier islands are long, narrow coastal sand dune formations. They lie parallel to mainland coastlines and offer protection from storms and erosion. Barrier islands occur in chains. They influence local terrain by creating lagoons, estuaries and marshes. Let's see the options. Which one is the right option? Come on, fast. 17B, how come, baby? Gautam, how can it can be 17BB? The answer is 17 is 4. Let's go to the next question. The Ganges River holds an important place in Indian life and mythology. Many locals and visitors are concerned that pollution and overcrowding now threaten the river. What could be the options? The 18th one answer is very simple answer, just the B. Okay, so this is about how you have to follow it, how you have to understand which one to put. I have chosen some really easy ones, so it was easier for you. most of you could actually understand, but we will do some tougher ones tomorrow where we will be doing about semicolons, we'll be doing about colons and dashes. So please stay tuned. Thank you so much. I hope this session was informative so that you could practice once again what you had already learned. I hope it will help you in your to make your score better. Thank you so much for your lovely support.